Hello students, this is Kulpreet and today I am elaborating you the second chapter of Book Vistas of Class 12 CBSE, The Tiger King by Kalki. I will tell you about the author, the theme of the chapter and the explanation. Ramaswamy Krishnamurti, better known by his pen name Kalki, was born on 9 September 1899. Kalki was an Indian writer, a great journalist, poet, a critic, and Indian independence activist. His writings include over 120 short stories, 10 novelettes, 5 novels, 3 historical romances, editorial and political writings, and hundreds of film and music reviews. About the theme of the chapter, The Tiger King is a satire on the conceit of those in power. Story is totally a blend of supernatural, humor and irony. The king's arrogance takes him on a path of destruction of the tiger population. The writer lampoons the king and the courtiers who surround him. He is too power drunk to notice the havoc he has created in his life. Now, the explanation of the story. The writer Kalki introduces the main character of the story, the king of Pratibandhapuram, who is also known by many names like His Highness, Jamidar General, Satavyagra Samhari, MAD, ACDC, and many more. But the conclusion of all the titles in one, he is often known as the Tiger King. The writer here promises his readers, even if the Stuka bomber threat him, he would tell us definitely why the king was called the Tiger King. Moreover, the aircraft, it means the Stuka bomber can go back, but not the writer. This shows the willingness of the writer to tell us the tale of the Tiger King. Further, Kalki says that everybody who reads about the Maharaja tempted to meet, but as in Ramayana, Bharat informed Ram about the Dashrath's death. Similarly, the writer is informing his readers that the tiger has reached heaven. Unfortunately, he is no more in this world. When the Tiger King was born, the astrologers made a confusing prediction that he would grow up and will become a great warrior, but one day definitely meet his death. At that very moment, a miracle took place. The baby prince, who was only 10 days old, asked a very wise question. What is new in such a prediction, as it is a universal truth that everyone should die? Here Kalki satirically compares the newborn prince's claim with the bulletins issued by War Office. Means the ability of a 10 days child was exaggerated because he was royal. Similarly, the facts are presented in an exaggerated form in the bulletins issued by the War Office as well. The Tiger King wanted to know the way of his death. According to the chief astrologer, the Tiger King was born at the hour of the bull star. And anyone who born at the time of the bull is killed by the tiger, because tiger and bull are enemies. Instead of scaring the 10 days old child, it means the Maharaja warned the tigers to beware of him. Slowly and gradually, the child was raising in an English environment. By drinking the milk of white cow, looked after by English nanny, and watching English movies. Years rolled by. Now he was a crowned prince and come to know about the prediction of his death. So he killed a tiger and called the astrologer. The astrologer avers him to be very careful with the 100th one, even if he successfully kills 99 tigers. Moreover, the astrologer promised to Tiger King that he would cut off his tuft of hair, burn all his astrology books, and become an insurance agent if the king would succeed in killing the 100th tiger. To overcome from his destiny, the king then onwards started killing the tigers and put a ban on the tiger hunt in his state. Several tigers were butchered by king with his gun, or when gun misfired, means when his bullet missed its aim. The king killed the tigers with his hand. This shows that he was a brave king. During his tiger hunt, the king faced several obstacles. Once, a high-ranking British officer visited his state. That officer was greatly fond of tiger hunting and wanted to get himself photographed with the dead body of a tiger. But Maharaja, on the other side, declined the British officer's wish. The officer was either a coward or was a non-violent in nature. He did not punish the Tiger King. He sent his secretary with such compromise. Let the king hunt, and the officer is very happy with his photograph with the dead body of a tiger. But again, the Tiger King refused the proposal of the British officer. But to secure his state from the wrath of the British officer, Maharaja sent 50 diamond rings to the officer's wife to choose one or two. But the greedy lady kept the whole lot, and the bribe cost him 3 lakh rupees.